Good evening, one. Good evening, all. Welcome, welcome. Welcome to the stream. Sit down, relax, grab yourself something to drink. Welcome back to another session of Starfield. Okay, so we last left off literally like smack in the lock, you know, the prison where Delgado is trying to find any clues whatsoever about the guy who founded the Crimson Fleet. Casper something. I can't remember his fucking name. Typical of me. But yeah, anyways. I do see people's points about load screens, though. I'm not complaining. Okay, I'm figuring out how to get access to that, aren't I? That was easy. Again, this gun is great. Wait, security? Is this what I'm looking for? Ooh. Oh, these are worth a lot. Ah, here we go. Section 2 release. That's what I needed, wasn't it? Yeah, it was what I needed. Okay, I should be able to get access to that loot now. Hell yeah. Alright. Boban Sesame. Rare laser rifle. Not ballistic, but I'll take it. Might be worth something. How do they get these cutters? Could have got a bunch of them. Anyways, we got some money out of this, so let's roll.
If we get out of here, remind me to thank Delgado. I'm gonna start crying.
He hasn't hanged us out to dry. We have separated from him. Settle down, buddy. Getting carried away here. Let's open this just for the XP. Well, that's not it. That might be it. I don't think it fits anywhere else. Yup. Fit anywhere else, alright. Oh dear, well, looks like I was mistaken. Ta-da. Still more of these, there's more of these alien pricks around. What is this? This is his cell, but... there really seems to be anything here. Hiding shit in a cell. Where would I hide it?
Can you imagine how angry the prisoners were when they rioted? I would hate to have been one of the guards.
The base of the lamp appears to be loose, pried open. Hello there.
Delgado was right. Crix must have hit the Galbank transport and stashed away the money or something. If we play this right, we're gonna be filthy, stinking rich in no time.
Where's that one coming from? Where are you?
You barely even count its target practice!
Is it on the ground? Oh, there it is.
Ugh.
place is starting to get to me.
Open door. And they picked this place clean.
Was this an armory? Looks like they cleared this place out.
God damn, that's a lot of money.
Well, well, what do we have here? Give me a sec. This ought to come in handy.
That looks cool.
Alright, let's keep moving.
See if I can modify my spacesuit somehow. Ballistic shielding. Yeah, right. Can't do that. Do that. That's a level 3. That's a level 2. All right, I didn't want to do that until I unlocked it again, didn't I? Fuck, that's all good. We're fine. We're fine. We should be able to make these again in the future.
And here I thought we were going to be doing something fun, like rob a bank or something.
I'm happy with those. Well, I've increased my damage resistance, which is good. I just want to take that. I can't afford it. Yeah, they really did pick this place clean. Just grab me some scraps.
Poking through this scrap heap.
Synapses do? Oh yeah, that's actually not bad. That'll come in handy, gets my with research. Especially with this new shit that I'm trying to unlock. Hello, safe. Oh, it's a corrosive puddle, okay. Yeah, it looks like the benefit's on way. Wayne, we're going to have to put a stop to the prisoner birthday celebrations that you initiated last year. I understand that the morale of the prisoners is directly connected to how well they rehabilitate, but these events have become far too destructive and dangerous. I know this is disappointing, but at the end of the day, we're a prison facility, not a hotel. These people are here because they committed heinous crimes against humanity, so they'll just have to deal with the loss of their parties. Here are this month's answers to the trivia questions. Oh, okay, the trivia things again.
A 100 years old, eh? It's amazing this entire place hasn't collapsed by now. Look at this dump. I can't imagine being stuffed down here to rot. Poor bastards.
Oh fuck, that's you. I thought that was one of the other guys. Oh jeez, what the fuck? There's a lot of them. Did they poison me? I just got lacerations, okay. Makes sense. I better treat that. Sounded like a mine.
Blows me mind.
that's a rare. Fuck it, I'll take it.
While we're picking through the trash, we might as well grab some good stuff for ourselves.
That's what I've been doing.
Can you imagine how angry the prisoners were when they rioted? I would hate to have been one of the guards.
I'll take that. 9 grand for a pistol. Not bad.
Looks like this was the warden's office. They built the office right next to the shuttle bus.
Okay. Yeah, this one was easy. Hey.
I hope you found something because I am getting sick and tired of this place.
I found information on Crix's legacy. No thanks to thanks to Mathis's help, we found some information on Crix's legacy. Where's everyone else?
I'm the only one left. Damn creatures finished off the rest of my people. But finding the legacy, that is going to make their sacrifice worthwhile.
Where are you right now?
Or something? It doesn't matter. Did you find anything or not?
Thanks to Mathis' help, we found some information about Crix's legacy.
I knew it! Everyone said I was out of my mind! But something told me we'd find the answers down here. Looks like I picked the right people for the job.
Yup, that's right. It was a team effort all the way. We had each other's backs the whole time, Del.
Is that Mathis? Tell him to shut up so I can think.
Yeah, sorry, Del. You go right ahead.
Okay. Now, all we have to do is find a way off of this planet. Let me see. Here we go. I'm looking at schematics for the lock. And I don't think there's a way to get you back to the surface from there. But I can open the outer doors to the shuttle bay and let you fly one of the shuttles down there directly up to the key.
Mathis and I take the shuttle. How are you getting
According
back?
According to the schematics, there is an emergency evacuation exit I can use to return to the surface. Then it's just a quick run across the ice to my ship, and I'll probably still meet you to the key.
What about my ship?
Don't worry about your ship. I will send some people down to get it. You just get your ass on that shuttle and get out of here.
You got it.
Good answer. You're learning fast. Okay, let me see. One of these probably opens the door.
Shuttle bay activated. Initiating the icing process. Please stand by.
Yup, it's got it. Might take a while, though. Those bay doors have not been opened in almost a century. You have done a hell of a job, Rook. We will talk when you get back to the key.
You happy?
Hey, look, I wanted to thank you for not being a jerk and hounding all the glory on this run.
You were the extra gun that got me through this place alive.
That's true. Well, thanks all the same. Look, about all that killing Delgado stuff, why don't we just forget about everything that I said? You know, like it never happened.
All right.
Thanks. I promise that you won't regret it. Now, let's get the heck out of here.
Hello, gorgeous. It'll be way down a lot. Alright. That's fine. It's only for a little bit. I can get to the shuttle from here.
Strong enough to carry all that.
Watch me.
Warden Tom Gillespie. Authorization 12210. This is likely to be my final log recording. The riots that started in D Block have spilled into A, B, and C Blocks. I've ordered everyone to fall back to the shuttle bay for evacuation. It was prisoner D03118, Jasper Crix, who led the revolt. His crew tunneled into the armory undetected, and then all hell broke loose. If the lock is recovered, I urge the UC authorities to perform a full investigation, as Crix undoubtedly had help from the guards and the staff. I'm now heading to my personal escape shuttle, and we'll try to jump out of the system. Wish me luck. Warden Gillespie, out.
Master Lock. Alright, what do we got? K1's already down, which is good. There we go, with that we should be able... Yeah, okay, so we got 3 completed. Now we just need to worry about 2 and 1. Oh, sorry, 2 and 4. This could work. Do that with... yeah, that works. All right. It's got to be the easiest master lock I've opened. Where it came from? I think it is. Yeah, it is. That's yeah, it is. All right. That ain't good.
Oh.
Oh, shit! God damn. Grab that. Yeah, definitely grab that. Yeah, we'll grab. I can grab all these. Gross, yeah. God damn! I'm gonna grab that zero. I'm about to open. Actually, I might have an idea. Since we're taking this ship. Stacking. I can't store any more there, that's all good. That will work. Still a little heavy, but that does help. You think? Hell yeah! How much space do we got in there still? Oh, we still fit three weight. Grab this the shit again once we're secure. You're no longer incarmed. Take off.
I have something. Orbital insertion done. Time to dance among the stars.
Fleet vessel ID recognized. Welcome home to the Key.
Ship is now on dock. Perfect. Didn't even smudge the paint. I'm all ears.
Ditch some of the junk, will ya?
No.
Man, the galaxy's too big to be stuck in the same place.
Hello there.
Too many missions, not enough time. I like my weapons like I like my coffee.
There you are.
Ah, it is a good day, yes? I keep.
Yeah, hold on to my resources for me because I'm about to sell the guns.
Stay safe.
Call UCC
Steph
Sharks.
What's up?
Now you buy from me, you can look good and protect.
I forgot something.
Stay safe out there.
I forgot something. I need to go back. Forgot something. Forgot the suit that I was going to sell.
It seemed that none of the wealth stole.
Any good books lately?
Not lately.
Any day you make it, there's a victory.
Sure.
If there is something I can do, I am always.
Got some good material there.
Look after yourself, I do not care what assurances you have been given that we are safe here. I do not trust the Crimson Fleet.
Believe me, I don't either.
That last job didn't pan out. I need something bigger.
The right protective gear can make all tactical gear.
Is Is that a shotgun with suppressed? Cool. Oh my god, it does so much more damage too. What the fuck? Oh, you can take it. Fuck yeah. I don't know what that gun is. I'm gonna hold on to it. I'm gonna sell these though. This just looks like fun to use. I'm gonna hold on to that. You can have that. You can have that. Laser rifle. I might give that to her. We'll see. You can have that though. Oh, you're broke. Never mind. How much money do you have? My view bar's blocking the vendor's money. It's up right. There you go.
Aye. I'm here if you need me.
Every captain here has earned their stripes.
Did you need...
Fuck it, you can take that. I'll sell the rest of these that you got. Let's suppress shotgun. The shotgun that I have now, so tonight, that still does more damage. And it's suppressed. I want that one. Actually, what I'm gonna use that. You can have that though, I'll sell that. Oh, you can get her to wear these, okay.
For the fleet.
I appreciate having your ear.
I've got what you need. Well, well. Neva's new hotshot. I knew you'd find your way back to my little corner of the key. Everyone always does.
What do you sell him?
Take a look around, genius. And don't tell me you've never laid eyes on a gun before. But just in case I need to spell it out for you, the merch I carry is known as Weapons and Ammunition. Get it?
Everybody's such a sarcastic assholes here. Not much of a corner, if you ask me.
Good thing I'm not here to impress. I carry most of the standard hardware. You know, kinetics, electromags, energy, even a few explosives. Occasionally, I stock a few smuggled items. Basically, the stuff SysDev doesn't want you to play with. Just don't screw me over, or I'll be inclined to give you a free demo. With your head as the target.
That threat might work if I was the least bit intimidated by you. Let me guess, trust issues?
Trust issues here. A little advice, Sadiqi? The fleet's trust can't be bought. You earn it. You bleed for the fleet bleeds for you. Pure and simple. Anyone who says otherwise is either lying or getting ready to stab you in the back.
I suspect this has roots in something very personal. Yeah, why not?
Please, I don't need your concern. All I care about is separating you from your credits. So let's leave our professional relationship at that, all right?
Is Roger going to stop?
Kinetic, electromag.
Yeah, I got some shit to sell ya. Enjoy. The Razorback that I got around here. You know what? I'm just gonna sell them. Fuck it. No shot. The perfect amount. Thanks for the credits.
Need more weapons or ammo? Come see me.
Hey.
Please tell me you know exactly. Just to make it quick. Oh. Bye, I guess.
I hope you do not have any loose cred sticks. I fully expect you would find them missing when we leave here.
Yeah, probably.
I hey. Hope you can. Don't even try to rip me off.
Weighing me down so much. I bet you it's my aid items. It's always my aid items.
Don't miss me too much.
Yeah.
I heard Isla's sister is
so... Going the wrong way. I need to go this way, don't I?
I yeah. Wouldn't get on the right. Smile, I want to. In the fleet came out of the mud. We grind for every credit it shows.
Sup? There you are. The hell took you so long?
It's about time. I was about to fly down and loot your bodies.
Not now, neighbor. Well, you said you found something. Hand it over.
There you go.
That's it? Just one slate. After losing so much of our crew, it better be a map with a big red X on it. Well, I'll be damned. Legacy wasn't referring to Crix's fortune. It's the name of an actual ship. A Galbang transport probably loaded with credits.
Never heard any stories about a Galbang ship going down. And even if it had happened, it would have been picked clean years ago.
No, neighbor. Think. If Galbang covered it up, and over time, the location was eventually forgotten, it wouldn't be on anyone's radar. Okay, this changes things. Now that we know what we are looking for, we have to narrow the search.
I wish Crix had been so cryptic about everything. How do we know someone else hasn't already found the legacy?
Because they would be rolling in so much cash, there is no way they could keep it quiet. It's like hitting the jackpot. Not to mention, they'd need someone with Shinya skills to keep the crypto tracing on the currency clean. And as far as Galbang goes, I doubt they would bother. Their bean counters would be too busy weighing the loss versus recovery costs. Now, the legacy is out there. Just waiting for us to find. I can feel it.
I wish Griggs hadn't been so cryptic.
I'm sure he did not have a choice. People would kill to get a crack at a score this big. I know I have. Let us start with what we know. It was a Galbank ship, which means the company is going to have records of where it went down. Neva, weren't you working on a deal with Rokov? Something about a big-wig charity event on one of Trident's Starliners?
Are you serious? I've been working on that gig for 3 months. That's my score.
Ay, Dios mío. Will you shut up about your score and think for a second? That Starliner has a Galbank VIP suite aboard, which means... Come on, Neva. This isn't hard.
Which means a Galbank exec will be aboard. We grab their credentials and get ourselves into the Galbank archives in New Atlantis. Holy shit, that might actually work. I'll send a message to Rokov right away.
Pack your bags, Rook. You're going on vacation. And since you've earned it, take this gun with you. Might come in handy when Rokov screws everything up as usual.
Oh shit, legendary pistol. Here's Rokov.
Rokov is... well, he's Rokov. A real pain in the ass. He used to run with the fleet until we kicked him out. Lately, he has been using his long-hauling skills to captain a Starliner for Trident. Gives us a contact within the company. He has been trying to get his foot back in the door with us for years. But I'm not ready to let him in just yet. Maybe you can use that to your advantage.
What's the Galbank Archives? What's in the Galbank Archives?
It's not what you're thinking. It's more of an office than a bank vault. Once you're inside, you'll be able to gain access to one of their computers and find out more about the legacy.
Always wanted to go to take a deep space cruise.
Good, because that is exactly what you are going to be doing. Neva and I are too well known to walk around the Starliner without being recognized. If Trident Security spotted us, it'd be over. I need you to board that ship, make contact with Rokov, and get me those credentials.
How do you expect me to leave things with Rokov?
You know what? I'm gonna leave that entirely up to you. If you think he's come through for us, you can promise him he'll get paid. But if he gets in your way, then you take him out.
All you need are the Galbank credentials.
I see what you are getting at, Rook. And don't worry, I would ask the same thing. Just be sure to get those credentials. Anything else of value you find on Rokov Starliner is all yours.
I'll get it done.
You'd better. Oh, before you leave, I wanted you to know that I took what you said about Mathis into consideration, and I've decided to let him join the fleet.
Why are you letting Mathis's future hinge on my opinion?
Because you're the one that finished the job. You followed orders and you put your neck on the block to get that data to the key. As far as Mathis goes, I'm sure you had to drag him through the lock and prevent him from doing something as stupid.
I think you made the right decision.
We'll see. That's it then. Next stop for you is Rokov Starliner, the Siren of the Stars. And remember, Rokov does not need to know anything about Grix's legacy. For now, it's just between us. Now get out of here.
Hey, Rook. Before you head out, I need to have a word with you. Meet me at the last Nova after you wrap things up with Mathis.
Hell of a job you did down there, Rook. Hell of a job.
Thanks, boss. This way. Oh, am I still uncommed? Oh, I am, right, the legendary pistol.
Something on your mind?
Need to see what...
Hold on to that for me. Appreciate you.
Another time.
Been hearing some stuff about the Mantis being back. If I ever find that bastard, the things I'd do to them.
I'm wearing the helmet. What's up, Mathis?
Hey, I wanted to thank you one last time for not ratting me out to Delgado. And telling him how much I pitched in, that was pretty damn cool. If he would have found out what I was planning, well, I don't even want to think about what could have happened.
You still planning it?
What? No, you gotta be crazy. All I'm gonna do is lay low for a while, pick up a few jobs from Voss, and maybe get drunk.
Don't worry about it.
I appreciate that. And look, if you ever need anything, an extra gun or whatever, I got your back.
I think we will be quite capable of managing by ourselves, thank you.
You just, take care of yourself out there.
No worries.
If you need credits, hit up the mission board.
Pirates? What could go wrong in
a... I know, right? Sup?
Settled systems on the run someday.
Maybe.
There you are. All right, look. I've been lining up a score with that asshole roll call on the Siren of the Stars for months. I'm not about to let a payday slip through my fingers. So guess what? You're gonna finish the job for me.
My friend's got a point, Bog. Every pirate in this joint comes to the Nova for a drink.
Seems to me, instead of trawling deep,
I would have slipped through your fingers.
My score involves a one-time event being held aboard the Siren of the Stars. If anyone finds out the Crimson Fleet's aboard that Starliner, the event will be canceled, and I can kiss my payday goodbye. There's no way I'm gonna miss this window of opportunity.
It would have helped if I knew what you were talking about.
I'm about to tell you, so shut up and listen. Volkov's been tipping me off about some kind of bullshit charity event that the Siren of the Stars is hosting. At the event, they're gonna give away something called Earth Savior Award, which is worth tens of thousands of credits. So it's simple. While you're on the Siren, swiping those gal bait credentials, I want you to grab that award and bring it to me.
How is an award worth so much money?
From the pictures I've seen, the award is set with 12 blue diamonds and covered in gold filigree.
Ah.
If I get Jazz to take it apart, I can turn it into a hell of a lot of cash. And best of all, the components become untraceable.
Does the Galbank executive I'm looking for have anything to do with the reward?
No. Dombrowski's only aboard to use the Galbank VIP suite, so he can catch a free ride at the company's expense. I'm sure he'll be there partying with the other spoiled brats. But I guarantee he doesn't give a crap about what's going on at the event.
I prefer to remain focused.
And I'd prefer to have the money that award's worth in my account. So you're just gonna have to deal with it. Look, you can make all the jokes and excuses you want. But if you don't come back with the ES award, I'm gonna deduct it from your pay. Either way, I get my money. How much you walk away with is in your own hands. Got it?
I suppose it is up to you to decide whether it is worth it.
It's not. Isn't Rokov going to expect a cut?
All Rokov does is feed me information. If I ask him to lift a finger, he gives me enough sob stories to fill a freighter's cargo bay. If you want my advice, leave him completely out of the loop. Otherwise, it's gonna cost both of us some credit.
ES reward?
Yeah, ES. Earth. Save you. Get it? Come on. Keep up with me here. I got about 17 other things to do and you're holding me up.
No, just take the pay cut.
You do whatever you want. I'm trying to offer you extra money and you're throwing it in my face? I'm gonna remember that. All right, Rook, we're done here. Now, get your ass to the siren and bring me my goods.
Why do I keep getting called Rook?
Because that's exactly what you are. A rookie, a newbie, fresh meat. Beneath all of that inexperience, I'm sure you have an actual name. But honestly, no one gives a damn. So get used to hearing that word. Until you earn your stripes, you're a rook to everyone in the fleet.
All right.
Good luck.
Box grog is fine.
Good many places I would rather be right now.
Don't worry, we're almost out.
Are you looking to start something? Because I'll finish it.
Always listen to Delgado. Unless you want to get full.
Ask Jazz about any ship upgrades. Nothing worse than.
Oh, actually, yeah, ship upgrades. Hang on.
Let's go.
Where is it? Doc. Thank you for the reminder. I can get some new ship upgrades. I got ship design level 1 now.
Time to cycle the airlock.
Ship services?
Loyalty's
you
big
need it?
In the fleet.
Sure. Sounds like fun. Let's see what I've got.
All right. I sell this. No. What do we got here? So, can I get a new reactor? Yes, I need a level two, rank 2 in Starship Design to get that one. Piloting 4 and 3, fucking hell. Yeah, okay, we can get a new shield at least. But I'm guessing this isn't compatible, right? Yeah. turn. Guessing it's not gonna work. Yeah. Yeah, even though I got a new shield, I can't actually use it yet because my reactor isn't the same. Lasers that I got now, they do 14 shield damage. Yeah, those are new missiles, they'll be fun to use. Ship design rank 2, okay. Yeah, no, that's not working either. That does 46. Yep, that's not working either. Can I really not get like any other upgrades until I get a new reactor? Hang on a second, before I do that, where's jammer signal? You see, I do want that. Can I store that anywhere? See, I kind of want this to help me hide my contraband. Doesn't look like it's going to be the case, though. Can I get new fuel cells, maybe? Fuel tanks? Okay, we got more fuel at least. That's not bad. Landing gear. Our landing gear is fine right now. Let me see if I can get a new grab drive. Max power. That's the one I currently got. Let me guess, this isn't gonna work. Yeah, figured. Okay, I need to get a new reactor. Like, that's a given. I need a new reactor. And I can't get that until I level up my capabilities. 3947, is that better? It is. Can I use that one at least? rename ship. The junk. The Badunkadunk. Yes. I love it. Alright, we got more fuel at least, so we can basically jump further distances now, making less stops. Okay, we've unlocked new shit, but we can't actually, like, you know, do with shit with it.
Careful you do not track mud on the floors. You would not wish to tarnish this hospitable environment.
I know, I know.
I got mess hall duty next week. Everybody's gotta take their turn.
I bet operations on the key are...
Sup?
You're back. So how did it go?
You've been monitoring me.
Even with our best intelligence equipment, we can monitor very little from the Vigilance. We can pick up local communications chatter and use long-range scans to see where you travel. But when you're on the ground, you're on your own. If we get too close, we not only expose ourselves to an attack, but we might blow your cover, and that could get everyone killed.
Why are you so surprised to see me?
It's because we've never gotten this far before. The last agent I sent to infiltrate the Crimson Fleet ended up in a morgue on New Atlantis.
Successfully infiltrated when I'm having second thoughts.
You stop now. Delgado will make it his life's work to hunt you down and kill you.
Not to mention the fact that you could potentially jeopardize the intelligence operatives we have in the field.
Lieutenant Toft is correct. I'm sorry. But there is no turning back. That being said, I believe you should be proud of what you've accomplished. I was certain we'd fool Delgado, but never. She's a sharp one, Overcoming her scrutiny is no small matter. Did you discover anything worth reporting yet?
Are you sure it's safe if I pass you this information?
I understand your concern, but you can rest assured that every member of this crew has been thoroughly vetted by both myself and Lieutenant Toft. Any information that you turn over will not be leaving this ship until it's fully encrypted and encoded. I give you my word.
How'd you know I'd be able to fool him?
If the intelligence I've read is accurate, Delgado is a charismatic leader, but a bit short on judgment. That's why you want to stay on his good side and stay away from Neva. She's shrewd, and she sniffed out everything we've thrown her way.
Delgado's searching for a Gal bank ship named a Legacy that was carrying some type of lost fortune.
Legacy. Why does that sound familiar? Wait a moment. Are you telling me Delgado may have actually located Crix's Legacy?
I have never heard of such a thing.
I'm surprised. I thought this was one of those tales that made it to every corner of the settled systems.
I suppose it's possible, sir. Intelligence picked up a bit of chatter on that subject recently. We assumed it was some sort of tall tale or a story to attract recruits to their cause.
Trust me, I've already been through all this with Delgado.
All right, take it easy. We prefer to check our own sources, if you don't mind. Let me see what we have here. Nope. There are no records of a Gal Bank transport named the Legacy in the database. I think Delgado's trying to manipulate you. What do you think, sir?
I think there's no record because Gal Bank is hiding something. Delgado's no fool. If he risked his own neck to get that information, then he must be on to something. We have to take this seriously. What's your next move?
Why do you think Gal Bank is hiding something?
Can you imagine the amount of embarrassment Gal Bank would have to endure if they listed a lost transport in the ship registry? Doesn't matter if that ship went down 500 years ago. If news gets out that a bank has misplaced money, it would tank their value.
I didn't know Delgado was with us at the lock.
That one's simple. We monitored your ships heading down to the surface of Suvorov. In fact, when he returned to the quay and you didn't immediately follow, well, we almost thought our operation was terminated.
I'm supposed to board a Starliner to steal Gal Bank archive credentials.
Clever, Delgado. Very clever. If I were in your place, I'd be trying to do the exact same thing. We can't let Delgado get his hands on what could potentially turn out to be the largest haul of credits the Crimson Fleet's ever seen.
Maybe I should head out to New Atlantis, sir. I could press the
Galaxy Project
for information. Get ahead of everything.
No. Let's allow this to run its course. We have our agent here feeding us information. I think that's good enough for now. There's more to this than just finding the location of the transport. Jasper Crix was clever. For some reason, he never got there.
I didn't know Jasper Crix never found the Legacy.
Because the Crimson Fleet would be a totally different adversary, and Crix wouldn't have disappeared years ago. Even if they hid the money with that damn human computer, Shinya Voss, our forensic accounting people would have found that data. No, the Crimson Fleet are in dire shape right now. They haven't seen that much currency, well, ever.
Should I put a stop to this by killing him?
And let Neva Mora take his place. Or Shinya Voss. Or any one of a number of pirates already gunning for his position. No. The solution is to stick to the undercover operation and determine how much of this is truly a credible threat.
Overseer has planned
then. It's imperative that you do. If the Crimson Fleet gets its hands on a transport full of currency, it would be disastrous for the settled systems. I need you to do whatever you can to bring us more information. And for God's sake, don't kill anyone on that Starliner. You're both dismissed.
You. I want to talk to you.
The commander appreciates the sacrifice you've made. Going undercover.
Why hold prisoners aboard the Vigilance when you could send them directly to prison?
Two reasons. First, Commander Akande's playing this operation extremely close to the vest. That means keeping prisoners under his own roof until this is resolved. Second, this is an undercover mission. For our safety and yours, we need to keep these prisoners out of the spotlight.
Will I have access to any SysDev resources while I'm undercover?
We'll provide you with information, but any inventory or ship services, it's best you get from the fleet. It'll help you maintain your cover and also give you an idea of how the fleet's operation works.
What other background information can you give me on the fleet?
They're pirates in every sense of the word, but they've managed to get more organized under their current leadership. That makes them especially dangerous, but hopefully it makes them a little more predictable too. I'll be here if you have any more questions.
Where's Baldi? There's Baldi. Oi, Baldi.
Do you have anything to report?
What is the primary directive of this?
Our directive is simple. Is the chief source of pirate activity. The Crimson Fleet is our primary target.
Okay, good cool. Luck. Well, I got evidence
for
you.
What can I do for you? Nice work.
Pick this up from the lock penitentiary on Sarovo.
It's amazing that all this romantic nonsense about Crix's legacy really just amounts to a rumor Jasper Crix picked up in jail. It just goes to show you how a tiny rumor can snowball into a full-blown fairy tale. Find anything else?
I found this in the warden's office on the lock of Sarov.
I'll be damned. So some of the UC guards at the lock helped touch off the riots. Everyone thought he was some kind of legendary criminal mastermind, but even the great Jasper Crix needed a helping hand to get out of prison. Anything else?
That's all I have for now.
All right. Keep up the good work. We'll be here if you need us.
Laters.
Heard you boarded the key. I can't imagine what state the pirates have left in.
Do what Commander Ikande says, and you'll go far.
Locks, air pressure, drive, all good to go, Captain.
Oh, we can't hail it? Oh, let's just dock then.
Air pressure, seals,
that's cool.
Ship integrity, all good. Docking is complete. Good work, Captain.
Just the weather, okay. I also just realized what might be weighing me down. Oh my god, I got so many fucking grenades. There we go. I gotta use up more fucking grenades. Let's throw the shrapnel once for now.
Excusez-moi.
Always good to speak with, if I can take a
onto that.
We will speak again.
Okay, so this is a long barrel reflex sight. I do want to see what that can do. Oh, so this uses the same as my submachine gun. Okay. Does more damage. Wait, what happened to my other gun? Where's my, Oh, my shotgun. Ah, oh, shit, did I accidentally sell my shotgun? Oh, no, I think I did. Whoops. The suppressed shotgun that I was gonna get. Fuck. Yeah, I got rid of the shotgun. God damn it. I'm pretty sure I should be able to buy it back once I get back to the thingy, but yeah, that's unfortunate. Instead of climbing all the way up, let's do this. It'll actually be quicker. Bored. Hey, little robot. So let me put that on. That my speech, just in case I need it.
About time you showed up. All right, I want to know what's going on. I've been trying to get Delgado's attention for, oh, I don't know, 3 years now. And what do I get? Nothing but radio silence. Then out of nowhere, just when Neva and I are closing in on a huge score of our own, Delgado orders me to help you out.
Why follow his orders if you're not in the Crimson Fleet?
Because the only way to achieve a win is by agreeing to play the game in the first place. Worst case scenario, I don't make the fleet, but I end up a couple thousand credits richer. That's almost a win-win, don't you think?
Want no formal tour of the ship?
Oh, sure, sure. First a tour, followed by a formal dinner at the captain's table. Let's get one thing straight. You're here for business, not for a vacation. So let's start by talking about Delgado's sudden olive branch.
You should be happy that Delgado is including you at all.
Happy? Oh, I'm thrilled. Still, this leaves me with a lot of unknowns. And in our line of work, unknowns get you killed. So Neva's message said you were here for Dombrowski. Was that all she sent you here to do? Or was there something else you were sent here to steal?
Why don't you ask Neva yourself?
Don't play games with me. We both know pinging a message back and forth to the key is going to take longer than we have to do this job. We're supposed to be working together on every part of this. So, you're gonna tell me what else you're here for or not?
Nope, there's only one reason I'm here.
Okay. So why are you targeting a Gaul Bank exec anyway? Not exactly your average Crimson Fleet prey. Why the interest?
What do you consider normal prey?
Merchant vessels, transports, supply convoys, mining settlements, you get the picture. But taking on a megacorp, that's a really big deal. Something the Crimson Fleet stayed away from in the past. Sounds to me like Delgado's either getting desperate, or this is leading to an even bigger score down the road.
Wonder all you want, that's all the information you're getting.
Oh, I see. We're playing this game now. Fine, fine. Well, you might as well turn around and hop back aboard your ship, because you're not getting near Dombrowski without my help.
It would seem we have little choice in the matter. We should hear him out.
I'm sure the fleet can slide some credits your way.
Oh, no. No, no, no. Delgado isn't gonna drop a cred stick on the table and be done with it. I don't want money. I want back into the Crimson Fleet. It's as simple as that.
You really think I have the ability to promise something like that?
You'd better, or you're gonna have to find another Gal Bank executive. As long as Dombrowski's on the ship, he's all mine.
What? You don't need money?
Of course I do. But who wants to settle for a one-time payout? I prefer to play the long game. You see, getting my ass back into the fleet means I regain access to Shinya Voss. And that's as good as an endless stream of credits.
Not sure what I want. I should have used my ability. I keep forgetting to use that ability. When I'm able to see their reply. You're in no position to make demands.
Fine. You want to play it that way. And suit yourself. Dombrowski's a full-timer aboard the Siren of the Stars. Probably spends more time cruising the space lanes than actually working. Fortunately, the Siren is hosting the Terran Preservation Society charity gala. Larry won't be able to resist showing off his VIP clout. To get what you need, you're gonna have to attend the gala. Talk to his fellow philanthropists and dig up some dirt.
Oh no. Is shooting everyone an option? Alternately shooting ourselves to avoid it?
What's a full-timer?
Someone with enough disposable income to afford a permanent six-figure cabin aboard one of Trident's finest space liners. Consider it similar to owning a luxury mobile vacation home. Plaything for the wealthy, you get the gist.
Anything you can tell me about the gala?
The event's a complete sham. Bunch of rich snobs getting together and throwing a party for themselves. These people couldn't give a damn about Terran Preservation or any other charity for that matter.
Any big dinner jacket?
Yeah, well, lucky for you, it's not black tie, so you'll be fine. This card will allow you to access the Starview Ballroom. If you need my help, I'll be relaxing in one of the upper-level lounges. Head inside and mingle with the crowd. No one likes Dombrowski, so they'll be more than happy to share his dirty secrets.
Hey, if there's any Aurora around, then it'll be a party.
All right, Speedy, take it easy. You're not gonna find that kind of junk aboard a Trident Starliner. Oh, there's one last thing. Trident equips all of their Starliners with the latest acoustic threat detection, meaning that you lose patience and kill anyone aboard the ship, security will be alerted and all hell will break loose.
I'm cool with that.
I suppose that's enough to get you started. Good luck.
You know anything about the, actually don't mention that. What's the deal with them?
They claim their goal is to celebrate the soul of the Earth, the culture, the people, and the ideals of the past. In their minds, Earth is now dead, which is why they feel that preservation of its remaining aspects is so important. In reality, this is what happens when folks with far too much time and far too much money get together to make themselves feel like they're contributing to society.
Why can't I just kill Dombrowski and take the credentials off? Oh, I can't say that. Alright, bye.
Oh, and while you're at the gala, avoid the canapes. They're frozen.
So where is it? Yeah, this one. Alright, so what do we got here? Got the government indication. We won't kill Larry. We'll get the ES reward first.
Between you and me, the best part of my job is getting a crack at all the leftovers.
Captain Rokoff said you're allowed in any of the crew specific areas. Just don't touch anything.
Maybe this won't be a problem with what I'm wearing.
In the event of a lockdown, remember to return to your cabin in a quiet and orderly fashion.
The society chair has really outdone herself this time. So, what brings you aboard?
Can you tell me about the Terran Preservation Society?
I'm a silver member of the society, but only 100,000 more credits, and I hit the gold tier. The society was founded about 8 years ago by Carl S.A. Worthington, a prominent businessman from New Atlantis.
Terran Preservation Society?
Donations to the society can be debited from my bank account on a monthly basis. I barely have to lift a finger to help. It is critical that the society keeps the memories of Earth alive in our hearts. I'm doing my part by attending this spectacular event.
I don't think you know.
Well, that was boring.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
That view is absolutely spectacular, isn't it?
Let me talk to the bartender here.
You cannabis?
If you want to dine at Captain Rokov's table during dinner service, it's only an additional 5,000 credits.
Hello.
You're quite a lovely starliner. Nothing but the best for the society, huh?
Do you know anything about Larry?
Yes, he's some kind of top dog over at Galbank. I heard he replaced someone that was caught running a fake loan scam.
Terran society?
Not much. Other than the fact that they host these wonderfully entertaining gala events every month.
Any information on the award?
Even if I was offered the award, I wouldn't take it. Can you imagine the security nightmare I'd have to deal with? No, thank you.
Good point.
That's all then? Okay.
I'm sorry, but unless you're reporting a security situation, I need to get back to my duties.
Mind moving along? I'm trying to enjoy. Sorry, I'm busy. Maybe we'll Gabriel talk Vera. Another time.
An open bar would have been nice.
Hey, dude.
I certainly hope they decide to hold all future society events aboard a Starliner.
Tell me about Larry.
Let's put it this way. He screwed over so many people. If he suddenly disappeared from the universe, I don't think anyone would miss him.
Award?
I heard it's fitted with 12 internally flawless 2-carat blue diamonds. Can you believe that?
And the society.
When you join, they send you a small chunk of rock from Earth itself. I keep mine on my desk. Nice to have met you.
Hello.
Hello.
Are you a member of the society?
Would you like a chat?
I certainly hope they decide to hold...
Larry.
I don't know why Larry's attending this event. He could care less about any planet, let alone the Earth.
You have any information regarding him?
That award is such a joke. It's for members of the society to pat their own backs for spending the most money on the cause.
Society.
It's a shame that the Earth ended in such a sorry state, but I'm glad the society has the nerve to do something about it.
Bullshit.
Don't forget to donate to the cause.
Quite a lovely starliner. Nothing but the best for the society, eh?
Hello, old person.
Have you tried the canapes?
Larry.
Dombrowski is married to some poor woman that he constantly leaves behind in New Atlantis when he goes on his business trip.
That might be interesting.
No. And why the heck are you so interested in him anyway?
Society.
Sheila Holbrook is chair of the award committee this year. The way she dotes over that glorified trophy, you'd think it was her own child.
Thank you. Society. Oh,
the society is such a worthy cause. What could be more important than the preservation of the Earth's spirit? Enjoy the rest of the event.
An open bar would have...
Okay, so what did I just get? Talk to her
nice.
About the reward. All
Trident's
right.
Gouging us for every credit we've got.
So, what brings you aboard?
Can I go in here?
If you have any specific requests, please speak to one
Hello.
Of the crew's
Hello.
Attendants.
Are you a member of the society?
Larry!
His behavior toward women is abominable. That man really ought to be ashamed of himself.
Award!
Sheila Holbrook is chair of the award committee this year.
Thanks. Society.
Is this about that feature SSNN ran a few years ago? I can assure you, this is a legitimate charity organization. Well, that was boring.
You guys are cunts.
Don't forget to keep your Starview pass handy at all times, or you won't have access to the ballroom.
That view is absolutely spectacular.
To make your acquaintance.
Larry!
He's been spending a lot of time with Claudia Swist. Quality time, if you catch my meaning. I'm certain his wife doesn't know a thing about it.
Thank you.
Enjoy the rest of the event.
Here for business or pleasure?
There's the stairs.
Is this important? I don't have a lot of time for idle nonsense. Yes, I'm extremely busy preparing for the award ceremony, so this better be important.
And where will the award ceremony to occur?
Probably in a few days. I don't want the award transfer to actually occur until we're safely in orbit at our destination. Of course, if I keep getting interrupted, the ceremony might never take place at all.
Isn't it risky to hold a reward ceremony aboard a Starliner?
Not at all. I was assured that this particular ship was outfitted with the absolute latest and cutting-edge security. I am completely confident that Trident Luxury Lines will keep all of us safe.
And you're in charge of the Earth Savior Award?
Yes, I am. Actually, I've been entrusted with the transfer of the award for the last 7 of its 9 years.
Damn.
Why do you ask?
What do you mean, the transfer of the award?
Well, the Earth Savior Award is one of a kind. The blue diamonds alone are irreplaceable. Since we can't produce a new award every year, it's instead passed from one recipient to the next. I supervise the transfer and make certain that there's ample security during transport and at the destination.
Has the award ever been stolen?
During my tenure? Certainly not. There was an unfortunate incident where my predecessor attempted to sell the award to the highest bidder, but that was quickly resolved. Needless to say, they'll be spending the rest of their life in a UC prison.
Must be nervous, keeping something so valuable in your cabin.
In my cabin? Oh, please. Why would I do something so foolish? I'll have you know that the award is locked inside the master safe, located at the purser's office.
Thank you.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I have much more important things on my agenda than to speak to the likes of you.
Bye.
Any complaints about your cruise should be directed to one of the staff.
So I need to find a way to get access into the room.
If you have any, this is not the very definition of decadence. I do not know what is.
Heard a computer. Oh, hi.
On behalf of Trident Luxury Lines, I'd like to welcome you aboard. Welcome to the purser's office. I'm Chief Purser Murata. How can I be of assistance today?
Can I store things with confidence in your safe? What exactly does she do in a Starliner?
Excellent question. My responsibilities include all of the Siren's financial, customs, and commercial goods transfers. Honestly, I really enjoy the work. I get to meet people at every port of call instead of being constantly stuck below decks.
Can I store things?
Oh, absolutely. The safe is magnetically sealed and shielded with multiple layers of fully damage-resistant, vacuum-proof plating. In the unlikely event our vessel is boarded and the threat detection alarm is triggered, the safe will be permanently sealed until it reaches port. In the even more unlikely event this ship is destroyed, we can assure you that your loved ones will be able to recover your goods from the wreckage. So, as you can imagine, your property will be completely secure until you decide to retrieve them from our safe.
Cool.
Please let me know if there's anything I can do
to make you stay more
comfortable.
I'm gonna see if I can convince her. Okay, so there's the safe that holds the trophy. Now here's what I'm gonna do. Quick save. I'm gonna take a thing to try to convince her. I can take a picture to save your
world. I've only seen it briefly myself, but I can assure you that it's quite lovely. Unfortunately, the item is locked inside of our safe, which can only be accessed by presenting an appropriate claim ID. Is there anything else I can assist you with today?
I'm fine, thanks.
Well, if you change your mind, I'll be here. Have a wonderful trip. I'm sorry. It's against Trident policy to discuss our personal feelings towards a fellow crewmate.
Persuade.
I don't want to lose my job. Why should I tell you?
Ah, that's okay.
I'd like to tell you. I really would. I'd like to think so.
Kind of just trying to take my point of view.
I'm trying to be reasonable here. All right, but you didn't hear this from me. Do you understand? I don't want to lose my job. I like Captain Rokov, but I think he's mixed up with some very dangerous people. I was bringing some paperwork to his quarters one day, and I found a slate with a message he received from someone named Delgado. That would normally be fine, but the message mentions the Crimson Fleet, as in pirates. Can you believe it? If you want to grab it, the slate should still be in his quarters, somewhere.
That could actually come in handy.
Oh, absolutely. The safe is in the unlikely event, in the even more so.
Okay.
Have a safe journey.
Okay, so I need to get the ID somehow.
Please remember to obey all posted safety and mustering instructions.
The society chair has really outdone herself this time.
Actually, if I can see what happens here.
Must you continue?
This is probably a bad idea when I want to do it.
Excuse me? And why in goodness name would I do something as foolish as that?
Persuade.
And why in goodness name?
Now you'd like to help me if you could. What's the harm if you tell me?
I wish I could, but if anyone found out,
auto-persuade you.
I'd like to tell you. Believe me.
I'm sure there's a way we can both walk away happy.
I'd like to think so. Oh, just take the damn thing already. Listen, maybe you can keep this between us. If the award goes missing, there's no need for the insurance company to get involved.
Thank you, Otto.
Nice. Trident's gouging us for every
This has been easy.
If this ship is any indication, I imagine there is an incredible amount of wealth stored in there right now.
There you go. Bye bye. Nice. How does it look? Oh, it's in a fucking case. Hello there.
Sorry, do I know you?
You don't know me, but I need some information. Yeah, you're in a hell of a lot of trouble.
Okay, that's a hell of a way to open a conversation. Why don't you cut the crap before I tell my partner that you're harassing me? Believe me, you don't want to piss him off.
I know all about your affair with Dumsky. Maybe I should ask Larry Dombrowski's wife instead. I'll bet Galbank would love to know about your affair with Dombrowski. Would your partner happen to be Larry Dombrowski?
Who? Look, can you just cut to the chase already? What's this about?
I'll talk to the wife instead.
His wife? Oh, for the love of God. I told Larry to keep his big mouth shut, but did he listen? No. He had to impress his friends and treat me like a trophy. Look, I've been in this business for a long time, and I know how this game works. So let's skip all the banter and get it over with. What's it gonna take to make us both happy?
Let me think about this.
Are you kidding me? You need to think about. For God's sakes, next.
Alright, so who is this chick? So she's the one having an affair with him. Do I need to get her credentials? I discovered America is having an affair with someone called her. I should speak to her and see if she's willing to give me more information about Dombrowski. Okay. And my thing's worn off, by the way, so. I need to buy some more of this. This is coming in handy.
I see it with my own eyes. It is
Thanks
still
for leaving
hard
me
to believe.
Have you decided what it's going to cost for you to keep things quiet?
All I need is incriminating.
If I give you dirt on that son of a bitch Dombrowski, all I'm doing is endangering myself. Why would I do that?
The Crimson Fleet wants this information. Trust me, he doesn't care about you.
I'd love to see that man suffer.
Find the information on one another.
That's true.
Oh, that worked.
You have come this far already. All right, you've made your point. You know, this whole thing really pisses me off. Larry and I had the perfect scheme where thousands of credits all worked out, and then he goes and flushes the whole thing down the toilet.
I do not understand. Your anger is focused on Mr. Dombrowski, but clearly the failure of this plan rests on you as well.
If you had to work near him day in and day out, I think you'd understand. He's a disgusting pig, plain and simple.
I mean, credits are we talking about?
I'm not gonna tell you. Let's just say that I'd be sent to prison for a long time if Galbank figured it out.
You hate this guy so much, why are you defending him?
I didn't know who the hell you were. For all I knew, you were working for Dombrowski. It's called playing it cool. You should try it sometime.
Tell me about this scheme.
Yeah, I'm getting to that. Larry got together with myself and this other guy, Gabriel Vera. He's some bigwig over at UC Security. I doctored the transactions, Larry wiped them off the system, and Vera kept the legal pressure off of us. We were scamming Galbank for months. It was going well until I discovered Larry was cheating everyone by changing each transaction in his favor before deleting them.
Hmm. Why aren't you worried I'll blow the whistle on the whole thing?
You won't do that. You're here because you've got some kind of side hustle in the works.
That's true.
If you wanted to blow the whistle, you would have boarded this ship with the authorities.
Why don't you confront him?
I was going to confront him back on Jemison, but then he invited me on this little trip through the stars. All expenses paid, first-class accommodations, the works. I figured, why not wait until I've milked him for every credit he's spending before I drop the hammer?
You think he was using you?
Oh, I know he was using me. At the same time, he was saying how much he loved me. He was stringing me along and stabbing me in the back.
If you want revenge, give me proof I can use against him.
I wish I had some. Maybe you should try talking to Gabriel Vera. He should be around here somewhere.
I just looked at him.
Just mention my name. That should grab his attention. Good luck. You're gonna need it.
What's your contribution to it?
I wrote a computer algorithm that basically creates a randomized number of false ghost credits that mimic the crypto key of actual credits. Then the algorithm simply passes the ghost credits to whatever legit transfers that the bank transacts. The genuine credits enter a dummy account. The best part is that I also alter the crypto keys as the real cash flows into our accounts. By the time it lands in our pockets, the credits are clean. So, on paper, it appears that all of the bank's transactions are covered, when it's really just our ghosted dummy creds. Genius, right?
What exactly is going on between that one?
What do you think is going on? I'm using that gullible idiot to get what I want. If I have to squash him on my way to the top, then so be it. Let's get one thing straight. Larry Dombrowski's no saint. He deserves everything that's coming to him.
Honestly, I don't blame you one bit.
Saints seem few and far between these days.
Dombrowski is a piece of human garbage. He'd stab you in the back for table scraps, then stab you again to steal dessert. The plan's always been to milk the guy for everything he's worth, and then leave him in the dust. Not bad for a lowly Galbank worker drone, right?
What was Jamborski and Vera's contribution to the Galbank scheme?
What, are you writing a damn novel? Fine. Vera works for UC Security, so he kept a lookout on their comnet for any Galbank chatter. I guess you could call him our early warning system. And Dombrowski made sure that all of the crypto manipulation I was working on didn't turn up in Galbank's automatic audits. You need top clearance for that kind of access, so we had to cut him in, whether we liked it or not.
Cheers.
I hope you hurt Dombrowski. Nail his ass.
Okay, I need to find the captain's quarters. How do I get to the captain's quarters? Because he has a information slate that can prove to be useful to me. Laundry service. Suite 5. Which one is he at? I need to find the crew quarters, that's important. Because honestly, the dude's gonna be pissed and I'm not chipping him in, and he's gonna be all like, oh yeah, I'm gonna stab you in the back now. Well, what's the bet? Hi.
We have a for
can
the safety
talk?
Of everyone aboard,
okay,
please
bye.
Be certain you don't interfere with any of the crew.
Several times, and I can assure you that the route is quite safe.
Where's the way that I came from? See, those are the guest suits.
I certainly hope
some storage and shit.
Hold all future society events aboard a Starliner.
You can find the crew quarters.
Designated passenger areas at all times. Have a safe journey.
I think this is where I came from, right? It is. Okay. I'm lucky I can actually get crew quarters. There we go.
This is one of Trident's top of the line vessels. Hell of a ship, isn't it?
You're a guest of Captain Rokov, right? Welcome aboard.
That looks like a locker room. Not looking
Captain
for the locker
Rokov
room.
Captain Rokov is one of the most easygoing best rooms ever worked under. Trident must have spent a fortune equipping the ship with triple redundancy.
There's nothing quite like the view from the Star View ballroom.
Captain's quarters got to be somewhere, right?
Every day that I wake up in my bunk, I count my blessings.
These newer vessels more or less run autonomously, which doesn't leave much for the crew to do.
Oh, we're here. Ah, okay. Go back. Set downstairs. Are these sleep pods? Could this be... Oh no, they're bathrooms. Did it say? Yeah, it does say restrooms. Alright, my bad. Okay, this is where the prick stopped. Where is... the area where he... Where's his room?
Captain Rokov is one of the most easy.
Captain Rokov said you're allowed in any of the crew specific areas. Just don't touch anything, please.
Between you and me, the best part of my job is getting a crack at all of the leftovers from the diamond.
I'm just gonna look for more. Waste time doing that, fuck it. That's definitely not the captain's quarters. This is definitely just the regular
this
cruise.
This is one of Trident's top of the line vessels. Head of a ship, isn't it?
Trident must have spent a fortune equipping this ship with triple redundancy.
Cafeteria. Crew quarters.
You're a guest of Captain Rokov, right? Welcome aboard.
Every day that I wake up in my bunk, I count my blessings to have.
Shh.
You can't hear the engines, can you? You're not the one to find better tube engines anywhere else in the saddle systems.
There's nothing quite like that.
Oh wait, this looks like... Here we go! If this isn't the captain quarters, I don't know what is. How do I shut this door? Captain, we received an incident report regarding Deck Officer Ken Lee, who was reported missing about a week ago. According to what I'm reading, it looks like you've conjectured that Ken Lee had a drinking problem and was last seen in a drunken state near one of the main airlocks. 3 minutes after deciding the airlock triggered, depressurized sections... Oh. Well, that's not good. Depressurized section 7A, and then Ken Lee was unfortunately sucked out into space. This sounds accurate. We'll continue our investigation from here. and any new information services regarding the incident keep us informed. Fucking hell. Captain, could you please confirm and advise on the following missing items from Voy 765. According to our dockmaster on the arrival port, these did not arrive as expected. 10 crates of precious metals, 15 crates of wine/liquor, 10 crates of synthetic cloth, and 20 crates of furnishing. Once you fill out the incident report, we'll start investigating. Probably just a miscount at the origin end of the voyage, but doesn't hurt to keep things safe. Captain, please be aware that Terran Preservation Society will be booking the Siren's next voyage, and they required full use of the Starview Ballroom. Extend every courtesy to their people and ensure that their event goes exactly as planned. This is a significant client, and we don't want to risk losing this account. We'll send specific details in the future. Captain, we are still awaiting answers for the inquiry regarding the Siren of the Star's last three voyages. On every occasion, the ship's cargo was severely thousand kilos lighter at the arrival port. Simply chalking these up to human error is unacceptable. May I remind you that the missing cargo holds a substantial dollar value that we're responsible to cover due to loss. If we don't have a proper report from you by the end of the month, we will be forced to launch a full investigation. Alright, Rokov, I talked to the big guy, and just like I thought, he said there's no way you're coming back. You had a chance and you blew it. How hard is this to understand? Between you and me, the only way you're going to get him to change his mind is by giving us something we can sink our teeth into, something big. And it better be good, because our last time was a disaster. Trying to offload 20 crates of furniture wasn't worth the time or the money, so never again. I'm going to throw you a bone, Rokov. No identity origin code, so we can't really use these as evidence. Got a deadbeat on your ship, one of the crew. Name's Kenley. He owes us about $4 large for some bad bets he made back on Neon, and now Vincent wants his head. Make sure Kenley misses his next trip, and we'll see about changing the big guy's mind about having you back. I think that's the guy he jettisoned. Good work on the Kenley thing. Not only did you send a message to every deadbeat in Neon, but you notched up a few ranks in the book as well. Only problem is, it wasn't enough. I'm going to need more. The big guy doesn't want to budge on this one. So you need to light a fire under his arse. You need a big score. Huge. Keep your eyes and ears open, and I'll see what I can do on my end. Got your message about the prize. That's about to find itself aboard. Now that's what I'm talking about. Since the event is coming up in a few weeks, I'll jump back home and try to convince someone to come out there and lend you a hand. Going to keep this one of a kind quiet or else everyone will want a piece. If this works out, I'm almost positive the big guy will change his mind about you. Might cost you a chunk of change, but you want back in it so you can play the long game, right? That's actually helpful.
I never had the patience for computer systems.
Okay, he should have a slate. Information slate. He said it had Delgado's name on it. I would not be surprised if it was in the safe here. Lucky for me, I got master lockpicking. Good thing I invested in that. See what we can do here. Okay, so that can work like that. Thank you. There's still four that I need to deal with. I think that works. No, it doesn't. What about that? No, that doesn't work either. Fuck. Not working either. Oh, but what if I do this? Which one was it again? Do that and I'll follow it up with this. That could work. That's gonna work. Let's do that. I got plenty of lockpicks, so I don't think it'll be a problem. How many fit this one? Oh no, that might work actually. Yeah, that'll work. Okay, so this one and this one fit there, okay. Yeah, this, which means this will be for the middle, small one. Then that will go into there, okay. Okay. Which means this one will be fine to do that. That. Go here, followed by this one. And that will go there, and this one will go around here. Not what I needed. There we go. Hang on, that might be something what. That might be something we need. Adam Oi. Rockover, once again, I'm refusing your request to rejoin. We're not... There we go, this is what we're talking about. We're not a membership club here, Rockov. This is the Goddamn Crimson Fleet. You don't apply, you try out. And if Neva doesn't put a hole in your skull, you get picked. That's how this works. You already went through this... You already went through it once. You had your chance and you blew it. If you want... to get my attention, maybe you should try scoring something valuable off that piece of crap you call a Starliner. Neva told me you lied about your record on the application to get that gig, so might as well put your position to good use. Cut the fleet in for a chunk of the creds, and maybe I'll start listening. Until then, stop contacting us, Delgado. Nice. Got the proof that we needed.
These newer vessels, more or less, run autonomously, which doesn't leave much room.
Captain Rokov said you're allowed in any of the crew's facilities.
Where does it want me to go?
This is one of Trigon's top of the line vessels.
Yeah, I figured there was something special about you. I mean, look at you, just stand out like a sore fucking thumb.
A bit lost in these surroundings. Hello, you here for the charity event?
Do you often attend honors and worthy causes?
Oh, absolutely. I'm a firm believer that attending these types of events tends to absolve one of their sins and cleanse their soul. But something tells me you're not really here to discuss the event. What did you really want to talk about?
Was it my clothes? I'd rather talk about Larry Dombrowski.
Dombrowski. He's the exec holding court over in the VIP area of the ballroom. Yeah, sorry. I work for UC Security, not Galbank. I don't really know him personally.
Claudia Smith says you have information about Larry.
Claudia sent you, did she? Look, friend, I don't know if you're just a little drunk, maybe a touch crazy, or both. Whatever you think you know about me, you're dead wrong. So back off.
We both know exactly who you are.
You don't sound very worried about Claudia's calling you out. Hand it over. Alright, let's try that one.
Why should I be worried? Anything you try to report will boil down to your word against mine. And since I work for UC Security, who do you think people will believe?
Huh. Well, that didn't work.
Get the hell away from me.
Anyway, I wanna see if I can redo that. Is it just gonna be the same thing? I think it will be. Hey.
Hello. You here for the
Larry
Dombrowski? He's the... Yeah, sorry.
Larry.
Claudia sent you, did she? Look, friend, I don't know. Whatever you think.
We both know.
Evidence?
Just in case you weren't aware, I am the authorities. Anything you try to report...
Yeah, same thing as I thought. How can I assist? Alright, anyways, moving on.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
My soul, you little exchange with Vera. Keep that up, and I guarantee that imbecile's gonna demand that you be arrested.
He's involved in an embezzlement scheme with Jabrowski and Swist. Does he actually have the authority to arrest me?
Oh, absolutely. He's up the ladder at UC Security. Lots of pull. We have to handle this very delicately.
He's involved in an embezzlement scheme with Jabrowski and Swiss.
Which is why he's threatening you. That makes sense. We need hard evidence of their scheme. It's gonna be tricky. The problem is he's not gonna talk to you in public. We need to get Vera isolated so he'll spill everything he knows.
Your bright emergency might do the trick.
Smart. If there's an emergency, standard practice is for all passengers to clear the decks and report to their cabins for lockdown. I think the best chance we have would be to tamper with the life support sensors. Manipulate a few controls, and you can fool the monitoring system into thinking there's a life support failure. And there you have your emergency.
Where the ship be with it, be
this
at risk?
This is one of Trident's premier starliners. That means it has the best of everything. Including a triple redundancy life support system. They installed a backup for the backup. Luckily for us, it will still trip an emergency and everyone will have to return to their quarters until I sound the all clear. Which I won't.
I'm not qualified to tamper with
it. Agreed. The consequences of getting it wrong would be disastrous.
You don't need to know anything about the system. All you need to do is access the maintenance area and throw some switches. One more thing. If Chief Engineer Sundin gives you any trouble, tell him I'll erase that gambling debt he owes me. I prefer you use that as a last resort, but hey, what's the harm in losing a few credits when I'm on the brink of rejoining the fleet, right?
Yeah, it's not gonna happen,
anyway,
bro.
I better start backing. Things are getting hot around here. Won't be long before Trident figures out you had help.
Where exactly is the life support system located?
There's access to the crew section that you can reach through the Starview ballroom. Chief Sundin should be there, wasting time at his station as usual. Have fun with that guy. He's a real piece of work. Once you're past Sundin, just look for the room marked Environmental Control. Everything you need is inside.
Once the emergency is sounded, how does the ship lockdown work?
All passengers are instructed to immediately report to their cabins. That way, we keep the halls clear and avoid a panic. Fortunately for us, all of the passenger cabin doors will automatically unlock. This is normally to ensure the crew can check cabins quickly and without interference. But in our case, it's like having an all-access pass.
Do you have the lockdown on, do you have the lowdown on Gabriel?
On the surface, he's an upstanding citizen of the United Colonies, pretty high up in UC security. Lots of clout with mast. Underneath, he's a greedy piece of garbage. Given the chance, he'd backstab you for a cred stick and pin the murder on someone else. Come to think of it, if he wasn't such a petty tyrant, he'd probably thrive with the Crimson Fleet.
Let us
go do something useful, okay?
Hello. Are you a member of the society?
G'day.
Hold up. This area is off limits to passengers. Wait a second. You're Captain Rokov's guest, right? Didn't expect to see you down here. Sorry to give you trouble. What can I do for you?
What do you do around here?
I'm the Siren's chief engineer. Trident put me in charge of the entire tech team. We do our best to keep the ship running smoothly and efficiently. Of course, this beauty is a cutting-edge piece of spacecraft design. Almost everything has triple redundancy, like the life support system. Unfortunately, that means there's quite a bit of downtime. Could be worse, though, right?
Kind of lonely down here, isn't it?
Yeah, a little. A few of the techs call this deck the dungeon. I think you can see why. Not exactly Starliner class comfort down here. Don't get me wrong, the quiet gives me time to gather my thoughts, catch up on work, and all that, but I'd rather work on the bridge.
I really need to get into the life support area.
Oh, sorry, that area is off limits. No exceptions.
Captain Rokoff is willing to forgive your gambling debt.
Oh, really? Well, that changes things quite a bit. Tell you what, I'm just going to step out for a bit and stretch my legs. Maybe you can hold this for me while I'm away?
No worries. Thanks.
Feel free to look around, but don't miss me.
Emergency procedures. In the event of an Alpha LSU-01 life support failure, Beta LSU-02 will automatically activate. In the highly unlikely event that Beta LSU-02 has failed, Gamma LSU-03 will automatically activate if a catastrophic failure occurred. Okay, yeah, so there are safety protocols. Okay, and they have environmental suits too. Lockdown procedures. If any of the life support units fail, an automated emergency lockdown procedure will be placed immediately into effect. All passengers will be ordered to calmly proceed to their cabins until such time as the captain of the ship deems an emergency to be resolved. If the captain has been incapacitated, please recognize the proper chain of command as per Trana Observation Manual SOTS-010207. In addition, all interior door lock mechanisms for passenger cabins nor mustering areas will be set to unlock to allow for uninhabited crew access. Emergency lighting and audio announcements will remain in effect for the duration of the event. Alright.
This is well maintained, to be sure, but obviously the credits have all been spent on the areas the guests actually see.
So is that it? Do I have to activate all three?
Nicer in here now. Plenty of room.
I know, right? Wanna dance? Just me and you? La di da di da. Is that upstairs or down? That looks downstairs. That's downstairs, yeah.
The ship is in a state of emergency. Please return to your cabin immediately.
Hello. Shall we speak on a more private matter?
A sharp contrast from the crew quarters, is it not?
I was wondering if you were the cause of the ship-wide emergency. It's time you stop playing games and tell me why you're here.
I want you to help me take down Dombrowski.
You want me to help you? Are you completely out of your mind? I help you by handing over evidence and I end up incriminating myself. Why would I do that?
Claudia says you've been cheated out on your
All
fair share.
May I have your
Claudia said
please?
That. You sure? Damn it! That means my money's already gone. And Dombrowski's going to walk away with a fortune. I'd love to see the bastard fry. But if I give you that information and it falls into the wrong hands, I could end up in jail.
Why did you let Dombrowski handle all the numbers in the first
Dombrowski
place?
Dombrowski had the authorization to wipe out records on Galbank's system without raising any red flags. I let Claudia talk me into that. She said she had him wrapped around her finger. Apparently, she was wrong.
Before I make any deals, you mind telling me what I'm buying?
Oh, I've got everything you're gonna need. This is a one-stop shop for you. We're talking a slate loaded with dates, account numbers, ID scans, even an audio recording. It was my little insurance policy in case the shit hit the fan. There's a solid enough trail here to send Dombrowski straight to jail.
Yeah.
At least I walk away with something. All right. You have yourself a deal. Here, with this slate and this recording to tie it all together, you'll be able to nail his ass to the wall. He'll do whatever you want. Just remember that you promised to leave me out of it.
I gotcha. What are you gonna do with him?
Well, since Claudia has been spending time disgustingly close to Dombrowski, I think she's suffered enough. On the other hand, I've got very, very special plans for Larry. I have some friends that can, well, let's just say, take care of the problem. That's if you leave him alive, of course. We'll just have to wait and see.
Midas.
You better tell Dombrowski to run, because if you don't kill him, I
will. Okay, need to head upstairs now.
There's no cause for alarm. I'm sure this is just a minor malfunction. Our security team would appreciate it.
Hello, Dombrowski. Let's have a little chat. Can you get in here so we can shut the door? You know, so it's more atmospheric. Thank you. Sup?
Well, well. You must be the one who's been accosting Claudia and Gabriel. I'm uncertain what you hope to accomplish here, but it appears we should rapidly enter into some sort of negotiation.
How do you know I was involved?
You don't actually believe that I'd venture into such precarious criminal territory without a proper bird's eye view of the situation, do you? I'm uncertain why you've become entangled in this spider's web, but this situation demands swift and resolute action.
The captain has declared a ship-wide emergency. Please report to your cabins in an orderly fashion.
Fine.
Excellent. Excellent. So, before we begin, let's review the facts. First, it's clear that you've obtained insider knowledge of my arrangement to defraud Galbank. The means and the method, perhaps, but not the motive. And second, I'm going to hypothesize that my compatriots are despondent regarding their share and have assisted you with this endeavor, Since we're speaking and I'm not at the reporting end of a bullet, this leads me to conclude that you desire something personal from me.
I haven't entirely ruled out the bullet option yet. Is it really necessary for you to... yet?
I see. That certainly places a damper on our negotiations. Perhaps I can hasten my diatribe to temper your violence-ridden contribution. In blunt terms, you have compromising materials about me in your possession. The only thing I have to offer in return are my Galbank credentials. I assume that's what you've been angling for all along?
Yep.
Will there be much more of this? My head is starting to hurt.
Unless you want copies of the stuff posted everywhere, you'll be kicking in some extra cash as well.
Quite a shame that you need to resort to blackmail to arrive at the point of equity in our discussion. However,
report to your cabins in an orderly fashion and remain there until you receive further instructions.
It appears we've reached an accord. Wait, I'm sorry. Let me simplify that for you. It sounds like we have a deal. Oh, of course, I trust you'll understand if I ask for us to avoid any further contact.
Of course.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to formulate how I'm going to utterly ruin two very annoying business associates. Good day.
We got it. Let's get the fuck out of here.
All passengers are being asked to return to their cabins at this time.
Whoops.
Stars is now in emergency status.
Hey.
Well, looks like everything worked out. Just like we planned. I wish you hadn't blown away the gambling debt that Sandine owed me. But hey, you got the job done.
Could have done it without your help.
I'm glad you feel that way. Just remember to tell Delgado how much I pitched in to help. You know, I'm still wondering exactly what you needed those credentials for. You feel like telling me, partner?
I'm not sorry, but he'll kill me if I did.
All passengers, may I have your attention,
so he told
please.
You to keep it from me.
The captain
I see.
Has declared a ship-wide
I wouldn't
emergency.
Want you to risk your position with the fleet
please
like I did, so
in
I'll just leave it alone.
And remain there
until you anyway, I suppose
there's
nothing stopping me from rejoining the fleet now. It's been a long time coming. I owe you one, Dover Beach.
What you call me? It's Tovarich?
Don't worry, it's not an insult. It's a very old Russian word for comrade. It's what I intend to call you from now on, so get used to it.
Cool, don't worry about
Nonsense.
It.
If there's one universal constant you can depend on, it's that Yevgeny Rokov always makes good honesty. Always. Well, I suppose this is where we part company. Hopefully the next time we meet, we'd be aboard the Key.
Thanks. Laters. How do I get down? Where the fuck am I?
All passengers are being asked to return to their cabins.
This way. It is this way, right? No, it's this way, apparently.
I need to pack up and get out of here.
There we go. And a single person was killed. Give myself a pat on the back for that.
All passengers, may I have your attention, please? The captain has declared a ship-wide emergency. Please report to your cabins in an orderly fashion and remain there until you receive further instructions.
Let's get the fuck out of here.
Any adventure you can fly away.
Clamps released. Air precious.
Wait, this is for, proceed to New Atlantis, apparently. Alright. Wait, what? Leave the ship. The fuck just happened there? Why'd it take me back to the ship? Ah, that's why. Okay. Now that I've landed the New Atlantis, I should proceed to the Galbank archives to look at any data on. Okay, that's right.
Been up there,
be careful, huh? If you run into those. Lives of nearly everyone.
Ah, shit.
Hello. Welcome to the... Galbank Archives. May I see your credentials, please?
Here you go.
Just one moment while I verify. Oh, yes, Mr... Dombrowski. Welcome, sir. Give me a moment to log your visit, and then I'll unseal the archives.
You're acting a bit unprofessional.
No, never. Not at all. I'm so sorry. Hey, look, please don't. Don't mention this to my supervisor, okay? She'll give me a low rating, and I'm gonna end up scrubbing floors.
Acting a bit strange.
Me? No. Look, this is my first day on the job.
It's an ambush, isn't it?
Okay? I can't afford to lose it. I got a wife and kids to feed. Everything checks out. Give me a moment to log your visit, and then I'll unseal the archives. There we go. Have a wonderful day.
It's a trap.
Contact.
Yep, no up. Oh, this gun's actually pretty awesome. I was not expecting it to be a burst. Okay, my camera just panned straight down for some reason. That was weird. Did they get up here?
Checking. Never know what you might find in my pockets.
That's not bad. Damn, that's a lot of money. Like both of them. That guy's for me to loot. I know there's some downstairs. Ship registry. Serendipity. Legacy. Classification transport. Credit to credit tank load. Approximate value. Classified transport on type CBR27. Departure point classified. Intended arrival classified. Banaco search attempt. 8 attempts failed. Okay. Wait, see what? 09A SROPS file. Prosperity. All Galbank transports have been fitted with CBR type encrypted transporter beacons. These beacons broadcast a predetermined long range and unique signature ping using high frequency hyperburst scatter arrays. The arrays ensure that the beacons are always broadcasting a maximum spread to assist any specially equipped search vessels. CBR transporters feature the latest in encryption technology, boasting military-grade ultra-bit encryption, fully cycling crypto modulation, and a cascading frequency spectrum. In order to properly track a target transport, please submit a request to the security office to receive a tracking cipher. The transporters operate via an independent, self-contained power source that allows them to remain detection capable for up to 250 years. Note that as the life of the power source declines, the broadcast reception radius will be gradually reduced. By accessing archived materials, we are hereby consenting to observing property materials belonging to Galbank and its subsidiaries. Any information contained within this system is for express use of Galbank employees only. Sharing the information with entities outside the Galbank ecosystem will result in immediate termination and potential criminal prosecution. Any concerns regarding these rules should be directed to Galbank Legal at New Atlantis. Thanks. Hey, can you hold some shit for me?
Sir. I am happy to help.
I'm gonna unfavor that one because I'm not gonna be using that one from now on. I'm so much lighter getting rid of those fucking mines. God damn. Should have done that ages ago.
We will speak again.
Where'd that prick go? He ran off. Fine. God damn.
Seals are locked and we are docked.
You want to kick back? Avoid the last Nova.
Thank you.
There are UC bureaucrats that must be furious that this station has become what it is today.
You're right there.
Next time you see Bog, tell him to light on up. Guy's got a real attitude problem.
What's up?
Your buddy Rokoff is aboard the Key. Told me everything had happened.
Yeah, he won't shut up about you. Keeps going on and on. Now I remember why we kicked his ass out the fleet.
Rogarvin's so bad he turned out to be pretty helpful.
Yeah, that'd be a first.
All right, neighbor, you've made your point. Well, since you're vouching for Rokoff, I guess we can give him another chance. All right, now that is out of the way, we can move on to the matter at hand. Crixus legacy. Speaking of which, let me see that data you copied from the Galbank archives. Ah, so the Galbank transport went down over Bannock 4. Bannock. Why does that sound familiar? Neva?
Yeah, keep your panties on. I'm looking it up. And I got it. Bannock 4. Let's see. Damn it. Bannock 4 is an EM class gas giant. You can't even get a ship near the thing without frying every circuit aboard.
Approaching that in... well, in any ship would be suicide.
EM class gas giant?
Don't know that one, huh? Well, pick up your pencil. There's gonna be a test on this later. EM class means the planet is giving off a ridiculously high amount of electromagnetic radiation. We're talking off the charts here. Fly your ship anywhere near one of these death traps, and you'll blow every single circuit on your ship. You'd be dead. In space. Get it?
There's gotta be a way.
Yeah, sure. We'll just wrap your ship in a ton of copper and launch you right in there. That ought to do the trick, right?
Both of you shut up and think for a second. I'm sure Creeks hit the same roadblock. All we need to do is figure out how he got around it.
This sounds like a goddamn waste of time to me.
The Legacy had a CBR-27 transporter. We could start by tracking its precise location.
The Rook's right. We tackle one problem at a time. Can we track it, neighbor?
That transponder is military grade. We're talking ultra-bit encryption, constantly reshuffling frequencies. We don't have shit like that laying around. But before you get that pissy look on your face, I heard that the UC's been working on a ship signal decryption system called the Comm Spike. We grab that little beauty, and we'll be able to track anything you want.
All right, here is the plan, so shut up and listen. Rook, I want you and Neva to put your heads together and get us that Comm Spike. I don't care if it's mounted at the top of mast. I want it. In the meantime, I'm going to find out more about this EM class gas giant problem. And I think I know just who to ask.
Give me a little time to crunch the numbers on the comm spike with Jazz, and I'll point us in the right direction.
You're gonna give up easily, do you?
We do or we die. That's the way Crix did things. And that is the way we should have been doing it for years. It's as simple as that.
We'll figure this out.
I promise. You gonna write that in your diary, little girl?
All right, that is enough. We are in arm's reach of Crix's legacy, and I don't have time to deal with this kind of bullshit. Now, both of you, get the hell out of here and get to work.
All right, let's get this over with. Follow me.
Do I still have the thing in my inventory? Yeah, there it is. Holy shit, it's worth 65,000. Hey, Neva.
All right, let's get right to it. Did you get the Earth Savior Award, or am I going to be very disappointed?
Here you go.
Well, well, look at that. You followed my directions, and now you're going to end up with some credits in your pocket. That about does it, then. Hell of a deal for both of us, I'd say. Anyway, here's your cash. Keep this up, and I might even start respecting you. All right, Fleet. We've all got work to do, so let's get to it.
Ask Jazz about any ship upgrades. Nothing worse than a pirate ship.
Let's head out.
I find the interior of this ship comforting.
Ship's no longer docked. We're free.
So I heard there was a bit of excitement on the Siren of the Stars. Your handiwork, I assume?
I was able to successfully steal the Galbank credentials.
Yes, and I heard there were no casualties. Excellent work.
Except for the Ecliptic Hit Squad that you took down at the Archives. We've taken care of that mess, by the way.
Speaking of which, I assume you copied the information from the Galbank's computers. Let me see what you got. So the Legacy went down at Bannock 4. Bannock 4. Why does that sound familiar, Doft?
Bannock 4 is an EM-class gas giant, sir. There isn't a ship in the fleet that could safely get near that type of world.
Legato will figure it out. How do you know all that?
The Bannock system was a site of a significant battle during the Narian War. I had to do a research paper on the subject at the Academy.
Delgado will figure it out.
It sounds like you admire that lunatic.
I don't mind, but you have to admit he's been clever. Somebody warning you about his resourcefulness.
Call it whatever you like. It doesn't change the fact that Delgado is still a murderer. Your best buddy has killed every single one of our previous informants.
That's enough, Lieutenant. Even if Delgado has an immediate solution to the EM problem, there's still the matter of tracing the Legacy's transponder signal.
I think something called a comm spike will solve the problem. Can you fly someone out there and trace it yourselves?
I'm not certain. Galbank uses their own proprietary transponder system. Even a ship as old as the Legacy would be a challenge to trace. And even if we could find the ship, we don't have anything strong enough to resist those levels of EM radiation. Unfortunately, we're hampered by the same obstacles as the Crimson Fleet.
Aren't you concerned that I'm helping them get closer to Crix's Legacy?
Of course I am. We don't really have a choice in the matter. There are no shortcuts. The route you're taking to secure Crix's Legacy for the Crimson Fleet is the only one at our disposal. If you suddenly change your behavior, they'll know something's wrong. I realize it's difficult, but I urge you to stay the course for now. In the meantime, we'll formulate a plan to ensure the Crimson Fleet doesn't get their hands on that money.
They think something called a comm spike will solve that
they
problem.
They have information about the comm spike? Damn it.
I'm afraid I'm not familiar with that device, sir.
No, you shouldn't be familiar with it. It's a highly classified project. It's an advanced signal decryption and tracking device that the UC Navy's been working on for years. How the hell did the Crimson Fleet find out about that?
There must be an information leak somewhere, sir. It's the only thing that makes sense. I'll see what I can find out.
Fine. This is what we're going to do. You keep playing along and go after the comm spike. Lieutenant Toft and I will see what we can find out about Bannock 4.
And we're going to warn the UC Navy about my attempt to grab the comm spike.
I don't see the point. The Crimson Fleet apparently has a pipeline of information flowing from somewhere within the UC military. Any attempt to move the comm spike would be a waste of time. We need to play this close to the vest.
Are you any closer to convincing the Council to attack the Crimson Fleet?
My superiors are stubborn. They aren't going to authorize an attack on the Key based on my flights of fancy, I've been told. We need more evidence that all the Crimson Fleet's plans will result in them actually getting their hands on this fabled cache of credits.
I'll put back many events are recovered.
Just stick with the plan and we'll see who gets to Crix's Legacy first.
Hey, I got some evidence for you.
This mission is going to require discretion on a number of fronts.
I have evidence for you.
Well done. Let's see what you found.
I found this evidence about Yevgeny Rokoff.
Tisk, tisk. Looks like Mr. Rokoff lied on his application to Trident Luxury Lines about having a clean record. No matter. Next time he jumps from the Key, we'll have him picked up. That will be one less fleet captain for us to worry about. Have any more?
I got this piece of information on a certain Galbank employee who was aboard the Sirens of the Stars.
Are you kidding me? Dombrowski was already making a six-figure salary, and yet he couldn't resist starting an embezzlement scheme. It makes me sick. Ah, it's gonna be an absolute pleasure to throw his butt in prison. That it?
That's all I have for now.
Understood. Keep searching, and you're bound to find more.
You really don't like talking about your past, do you?
You're not gonna let this go, are you? Why do you care so much about my past?
Since I'm entrusting Sis Steph with my life, I deserve to know who's got my back.
Okay. But don't say I didn't warn you. You might not like what I have to say. Would it shock you to learn that I spent some time in prison? I suppose that makes me a hypocrite.
Quite the opposite. Explains a lot. Why does that make you a hypocrite?
Oh, come on. I haven't exactly been cordial about my feelings towards the Crimson Fleet's illegal activities.
Quite the opposite. He explains quite a lot.
Oh, does it now? Was I giving off some kind of ex-con sort of vibe? Well, give me a chance to explain. I grew up in the Well in New Atlantis. Parents made barely enough money to keep the lights on in our apartment. After I dropped out of school, they begged for me to look for work. But I realized it was a lot easier to simply take whatever I wanted instead. A year after that, I'm a career criminal with UC security breathing down my neck, and my parents kicking me out of the house.
So you lived on the streets?
Hell no. I made enough money to buy my own apartment, filled it with some decent stuff too. I'd even send pictures of the place to my folks to rub it in. I was a real asshole. Well, I wasn't a nice person.
You did what you had to do.
That's just it, though. I was having the time of my life, earning way more than I needed to simply get by and loving every minute of it. Back then, if you would have told me one day I'd be wearing this uniform, I'd have said you were out of your mind.
Yeah, look at you now.
Thanks. I'm quite proud of where I've ended up. Let's just say the years after my time in the well were filled with highs and lows. Look, the point is that I felt you deserved to know a bit about my past, to know where my anger towards the fleet comes from.
Thanks for sharing it.
You're welcome. Well, I think you've had enough for now. You get the point. Let's get back to it before Keyboy writes us a citation for loitering.
Do you know where it's being developed?
That information is classified, so even what I do know, I can't divulge. Now, I realize as part of this mission, you'll probably end up finding out anyway, but that's besides the point. For the sake of your cover, it's best you work with whatever information the fleet gives you.
True. What can you tell me about the comm spike?
I know as much as you do. I wasn't briefed on this particular device. But if the fleet wants to trace the Legacy's transponder signal, they'll need something beyond the decryption tech we have currently. If such a device exists, it's likely being developed by the UC.
Cheers.
We'll be here if you need
us. Well, it's getting late, guys, so I am gonna end it here. Did I get it? Oh no, I thought I got a skill point for some reason. Alright, let's drop a save, and that's it for me tonight. Alright, guys. Well, firstly, I'd like to thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Alright, everybody. Take care. And have a good one.